Sisters and six big bros. She's bad for my heart, but good for my soul. My sex life's weird, and my cholesterol is out of guy. My sex life's weird, and my cholesterol is out of control. I brought it to my house and hard boiled her, pampered her. To wake you guys up. I didn't know if I had put you to sleep. I brought it to my house and hard boiled her, pampered her and spoiled her. Now she can't get enough of my dick. I took her to Broadway to see Wicked. I only had to buy one ticket. One time I almost ate her. Luckily I remember that I date her. Sweet Lord, there's no love greater than the kind of my refrigerator. And that's the story of my life. The story of my life. I thank you very much, guys. This is exciting. It's Monday night.
Coming to you live from the world famous comedy store for a brand new episode of Kill Tony Volume 3. Give it up for Tony Hinchcliffe!
Yeah. Yeah. Hi everyone. Welcome everybody. Come on in. Make yourselves cozy. Happy Monday, live audience. How are you guys? Woo! Half-ass energy in this room right now. It's fun. Keep it going for Pat Reagan, everybody. Emotional stuff to get the audience pumped up tonight. Not really the warm-up that part, but definitely a performance. Pat, how you doing over there? Looks like casual Pat tonight. You got the glasses, the ball cap. This is new.
I'm good, man.
I love it. All right. Fuck yeah. That's all we're gonna get from Pat, right? J.E. Bell is missing in action right now. He's out in Texas visiting family for Christmas, where we're going to be this Saturday and Sunday. Live Kill Tonys from Austin and Dallas.
Yeah.
Get your tickets now at SpiderHouseAustin.com and HyenasComedyNightclub.com or something like that.
Yeah, it's the easiest way. Just go to DeathSquad.tv, click on tour dates.
Yeah, do that. We're there this Saturday and Sunday, live, doing the show that you guys are at its home field right now. Woo! Live show, baby. Anything can happen. And we have fun every Monday, and that's pretty much just about it. I'm going to be headlining Caroline's in New York City the first weekend in February. Woo! That's a first. Oh, that's a first. Thank you. So for all of you that are from New York and listening in New York, that's where I'm going to be, first weekend in February.
Don't you have better news that you announced today?
Yeah, but I'm not going to announce it here. I'm gonna announce it annoyingly every single week after this, but not on this one. All right. Anyway, hi everybody. Let's have some fun, shall we? You guys ready for a crazy night or what? You know what happens here. Every single week, a bunch of people sign up to do comedy in front of some of their favorite comedians and us, and we talk to them about their performance and maybe other things that these new, young, rising comedians can talk about in their lives. So, just like with every other week, I have two of the funniest comedians in the world here to talk with them. Put your hands together for them. It's Jeff Garlin and Doug Benson.
Chill green room.
Very mellow back there.
Yeah, so I was just chilling. What do you want from me? Yeah, so there you go.
Hi, Jeff.
And then
welcome
I had
back.
To come up to Susu Studio.
You big Phil Collins fan?
Actually, you know, his first solo album and like a couple of the Genesis albums are pretty good. Mm-hmm.
Trouble is, Jeff's parents were murdered to that song. So it's always sad. It's a spin on, remember,
you
know,
are
Sarah,
so fucking high right
now. You know how. You know how Sarah Silverman, you know Sarah Silverman's joke when they, whatever they play her on to, with, she says, I was raped to that song? Like, that's her opener?
Yeah, so you thought you'd do a version of it.
I did a twist on it. Yeah. Your parents were murdered to Susu Studio.
Speaking of music that makes you feel like you're being raped, did you guys get to hear Pat Reagan at all tonight?
Oh, he was killing it.
The energy in the room before the show started?
It's the best performance I've heard through a closed door in my entire life. So good. It put Jeff to sleep over there. Yeah, and that's a great compliment for music. You want a music that'll help you go to sleep.
Maybe that could be your niche, Pat, the lullaby album selection. You know, just put people to rest with your rock and roll.
The James Taylor genre. Ooh, it got quiet.
Yeah, yeah, no, we heard it got quiet. Yeah, no need to ask if we heard it. You love it. Only you can summon that kind of silence, Pat. It's incredible.
Can you do an acoustic Susu Studio right now?
I don't know.
I don't think you can.
No, I couldn't.
I challenge you.
And I removed that challenge.
Fuck yeah. Well, we're going to have some fun. You guys
challenge rescinded.
You guys have both done the show before. Both two of our favorite returning guests. You guys know how it works. Comedians, you get six...
I don't remember how it works.
All right.
It's not like it was a strong memory of my past.
A bunch of
I was here and I enjoyed myself, so I'm back.
The last show you were on was with Sinbad.
Yeah, and, he was funny and nice.
Yeah, he's great.
He's a good guy?
Yeah, he was a good guy.
Nice.
Yeah, it was nice. No, you know what I mean?
It's good, like, to hear.
It is good,
yeah,
to hear.
It's hard, yeah, to be, it's hard to not be, it's hard to be cool. It's hard to be cool with a name like Sinbad. It's grandiose.
Yeah, yeah, it seems like two negative words, like both sin and bad, but he's such a good guy. Anyway,
let me remind you how he does clean comedy, and his name is Sin and Bad.
Exactly. Jeff, I'll remind you how things go. A bunch of comedians in the back of the room, they sign up for the chance to do 60 seconds uninterrupted by getting their name pulled out of this bucket. And then
that's right. I think it's stupid. And then,
you loved it last time you were on.
No, 60 seconds is bullshit, man.
It's pretty quick.
It's just for us to get
it. Make me laugh, you know, the rerun or whatever. No one has saw that.
But it's not about the performance. It's just getting to know them so that then we can talk to them about anything in the world.
Oh, okay. Well, that's fine. Whatever.
And they get 60. They get 60 seconds uninterrupted. Okay. Comedians, you know,
you. I don't just ruin your podcast.
Yeah, no, you're uniformly ruinacious.
By the way, do you know how many people came up to me about the Traverse City show. A lot of people came up to me. They would listen.
What would they say when they came up to you?
That they loved it. That was really fun.
That's interesting. So the ones that didn't like it were probably kept quiet and walked by.
Yeah, that's what usually happens. People who think I suck don't stop.
They don't
me.
Say anything. Yeah. No, hey. You were annoying on that show. No, that doesn't happen, generally.
Generally.
Happens on Twitter.
Yeah, of which where I don't have, I'm not there.
You don't dwell?
Yeah, I noticed that.
I had like 150,000 some odd followers and I just deleted it.
Oh.
I did it about a year and a half ago.
What made you do that?
Yeah, Twitter's stupid.
Would you still do it if you knew that 150,000 people all perished?
No, I would not.
You killed all of them. I hate to break it to you this way, but you killed all those people.
If I actually knew that deleting my account, everyone who followed me died because of it, I would not delete my account.
I would certainly think about it.
Anyway, guys, so again, back on the track we go. Thanks, Doug, for steering it the opposite direction.
Why don't you say this? Thanks, hi, guy.
I'm just saying, genocide is fun, especially if it's just one button push.
All right, so speaking...
What the fuck are you talking about? What is this? This is stupid as shit.
Jeff, you're still asleep.
By the way, for those of you who don't know, I just want to make it clear, I love Doug Benson. So no matter what I say to him tonight, just know I love him.
Yeah, just know that, you guys, because it's going to get super ugly.
But you know it too, you fucking loser. We've been friends 100 fucking years, so
it's true.
Okay,
yeah.
So go ahead.
So the comedians sign up for 60 seconds. They know their 60 seconds is up when they hear the sound of a kitty.
Oh, was that what it was last time?
Did you hear
time?
That? Yeah.
Yeah, that's sweet.
Yeah, it's adorable. But they have to wrap it up then, or else they're going to bring out the angry West Hollywood bear.
Was a bear with a firearm?
No, it's a bear that was murdered because it was involved in a comedy store.
It's an armed bear
wandering around, and they shot an armed bear.
I actually remember the last time that you were on the show, Jeff, you said that the angry West Hollywood bear should just sound like, rawr.
Oh, yeah, a little like a gay bear. Yeah. And that'd be fun and easier.
Yeah.
And it also wouldn't hurt my ears as much as that last thing.
Yeah. It's
who doesn't like a good West Hollywood gay bear?
That's right.
Well, a bear, it means you're like a big, like I'd be big, if I was gay, I'd be big in the bear community.
Yeah,
that's like
you're bearish because you're always
bearish.
Losing weight. You're looking good.
Yeah, you know? But I learned that from John Waters.
Giant
that
bear,
big in the bear community. I didn't know what it was until he told me.
Yeah,
I wonder was they taught me because I wasn't going to school to learn the world of gayness. But he told me about this. I worked with him.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go.
Leonardo DiCaprio gets raped by a bear in The Revenant.
Is that true?
No, but it looks like. It looks like it's raping him. It's just mauling and murdering him.
All right. I pulled the name out of the bucket. We're going to give this guy 60 seconds uninterrupted. Ready for it? Put your hands together for the stylings of a guy named Anthony Calhoun.
Anthony, you're taking a long time to stop.
Wait, Jeff. Wait, we don't talk.
Seconds.
We don't talk
uninterrupted a couple of times.
It's the one part that you can't talk at, Jeff. Anthony Calhoun, everybody. Come on.
So, any
Anthony, that.
Okay.
We won't count again. We'll start it fresh.
Anthony Calhoun, everybody.
All right, so I'm sure that some of you know or have heard of Richard Simmons. If you're as old as I am or older, you remember back in the day on those VHS tapes, they had the sweating to the oldies. I thought it would be kind of cool if they brought back Richard Simmons, except for they could call it sweating to the newbies. Well, that just sounds like a porn. Fuck, I'm pretty high right now. I heard that Doug Benson was probably going to be here, so I smoked weed, which is probably a bad idea. It's really fucking with my set.
Yes. Did you just did his own meow? He gave his own
meow. Oh my god, I've never seen that in
You chose to do this shit. Don't blame yourself. Don't blame others. You seem nervous. You okay?
Yeah, I'm pretty fucking nervous.
Are you freaking out from the pot?
No, he'd be worse if it wasn't for the pot. He'd be really shaking if
he
didn't get high first.
I have one question in terms of his material.
I have a lot of them.
The first question is, they should bring back Richard Simmons. They should call it. Who are they?
Fucking the Illuminati.
The Illuminati?
Wow. All right.
We're heavily involved in Richard Simmons' career.
I love it.
For how nervous you are, you had a really cocky answer there.
The Illuminati, Jeff. What's wrong with you?
The conspiracy.
I put on my best sweatpants to do this performance this evening.
Are those chef's pants?
They are, actually.
Are you a chef?
I used to clean kitchens.
Wait, wow. You recognize those as chef pants?
They are chef
pants. Are those the pants worn by Jon Favreau in the movie of the same name?
No.
Wait, hold on here. You call him Jon Favreau?
Jon Favreau.
That's awesome.
Wow, chef pants. I never heard of such a thing.
Oh, well, yeah, it's a whole thing. Chef's pants look exactly like that. Little did I know that the people that scrub the floors also wear the same pants. Like, it seems a little bit off. It's like how the nurses also wear surgeon stuff.
Get out of
here, handsome boy stuff.
Thanks, Jeff.
Just for you listeners who've never seen Tony, he's a handsome boy. So listen, man.
You got fucked at the start by Jeff and his bullshit, and you got high as an excuse. Like, you know, try it again sometime without getting high first. I did it for a long time without getting high, but I was able to work my way into it.
Here's another piece of advice: is no, even if you would have killed your entire 60 seconds, I wouldn't even have noticed it because I was so mesmerized at how unbathed you look.
No, to me it looks completely.
Are you talking about the cum that's on his shirt?
No, I
took a really fucking quick shower and I literally ran down here, so it was like,
so you're wet. That's what's going on.
Did your hair get wet in the shower?
Briefly.
Come on, tell the truth here.
He doesn't smell. Tell the truth.
You're trying to answer.
It doesn't smell bad.
No, here's.
How do you know?
Can we right here next to him. That's not that close. I can smell Brian's breath from here.
Can we cut to the core? Can I just get to the core with him?
Yeah.
What's your name again, Brian?
Anthony.
You said Brian. That's Brian right there. Yeah. So Anthony. What are your dreams? What do you want out of life?
Shit, man, there's a lot of... I mean, honestly, if you were going to get the whole perspective, it's pretty broad, but I just want to fucking make people laugh and hopefully get paid for it, whether that ends up being directly with comedy as stand-up or, like, improv, like, sketch writing, or...
Okay, I was going to say, it sounded like you were going to have a fallback. Like, you shouldn't have a fallback. You should just dive in.
It's all... Can I be honest
with you? Yeah. You got kind of a funny persona. Yeah, good luck. No, there are people who like say that shit who I just, in my head I go, oh dear God. I'm not saying oh dear God, I'm saying oh maybe, I don't know.
Where are you from, Anthony?
Most recently, Nebraska.
Hold on a second. Where are you from most recently? Where you're from changes?
I was born in Alaska, raised in Oregon, and then after high school.
Were you born in Oregon? Place.
No, born in Alaska.
In Alaska. See, that's the most interesting answer that you could give.
Yes.
I'm from San Diego. No, you were born in fucking Alaska. Go with that one. That's my starter advice. Other than that,
that is terrific advice. Yeah. It really is, because you're already interesting. Because who's from Alaska?
Right.
The people that live there.
I lost my virginity in Juneau. You never hear that thing.
I lost my virginity in Juneau, 1980.
Where did you lose your virginity?
Actually, here in L.A. Not this time, like 14 years ago.
So you can also be funny on a podcast not knowing you're funny.
Sure.
Yeah, you have no idea why everybody laughed at that last time. Always stick your tongue out when you get excited. You do like this rock and roll thing. Do you know that?
Did you know you're a character? I think he's got potential. He just needs to work on the writing and the shaking.
Are you saying that you wouldn't have smoked pot had you not known that Doug was going to be the guest?
No, I guess.
I think he just said that just because it's a fun thing to say.
Yeah, and I'm not gonna lie, I was trying to impress Doug.
Yeah.
I'm trying to show off. Like, this is my third
time on
stage.
That's all it takes to impress Doug is tell him you're high.
Yeah.
Well, how about that? Look at you.
So your Richard Simmons joke, let's break that down. What was the actual joke?
No,
we don't need to break
that down.
What are you doing?
What is happening? Who the fuck are you breaking down the...
We don't need to break that down.
We don't need to break that down.
That was nothing.
You know, I once spent an afternoon at Richard Simmons' house.
Really?
Yeah, in his kitchen, looking at his doll collection. I spent a day in his house, yeah. Wow. It was also a day that Northwestern upset Notre Dame. It was like a big upset. And people told me about it, and I couldn't say, oh, I didn't see the game, because I was like, Richard Simmons. But I was.
Yeah, there's a thing going, he hasn't been seen in, like, I think a year or 2 years recently, and there's, like, this whole conspiracy about Richard Simmons, like, that he might be being changed into a girl, like, the last couple years.
You're making that shit up?
No, I'm saying there's a conspiracy.
No, I don't know where you're reading the shit.
He showed up here and there in the last few years.
No, by the way, I don't like you. I don't like what you're saying. You're the problem. The music guy was bad enough, but now you... Oh, fuck. What kind of show do you run? But you're good. You go with your dreams.
Anthony Calhoun, everybody. Welcome to Time Frame.
Follow your dreams. He's already win second place in a DC Pearson lookalike contest.
So what? Slide. That was nice.
You like that?
Yeah, it's a little... Yeah.
Look at that. Yeah, he's got a thing on his finger. And a little... Little black snake moan, I love it.
I like that.
Oh, you said you didn't like me. Little man thimble.
What's that?
You said you didn't like me.
I don't know you. I can't really make a definitive thing unless I have a conversation.
He's just prejudging you.
Yeah, but a little slide always makes everybody happy.
Remember that, Brian?
Yeah. Need a little slide.
Put a little slide on that bear noise.
I'm gonna pull another name out of the bucket. I encourage you to start quickly after you hit the stage. Put your hands together for Doug Key.
Says it's a person who is afraid of homosexuals, but actually there's two kinds of homophobes. You've got a person who is afraid of homosexuals and a person who is afraid of being a homosexual. You know these guys that are talking about they're trying to turn me gay. They want to turn me gay. They can't do that. What they can do and what they will gleefully do is turn you out, honey. You got any lightness at all in your loafers, they will find it. They will polish it up and they will roll it in glitter for you. I mean, everybody's a little bit gay because everybody masturbates, and masturbation is just you getting gay with yourself. That's about a minute, right?
Yeah, it's 54 seconds. Fuck yeah. Doug Key. The second ever Kill Tony performance. Last time we saw you was last week for the first time. And I remember he's
2 weeks in a row.
Yeah.
I got lucky.
What did you talk about last week?
Jism.
I talked about my psychiatrist told me that my problem is I couldn't love myself, but thanks to him I found out, I thought I was in love with myself, but I found out it was just a physical thing.
So you get, so in your first 2 minutes on Kill Tony, you're pretty much masturbation all the time.
Yeah, it's from experience, you know.
Yeah, no, yeah, right about what you know, but nobody wants to know about what you're doing. Like, I mean, I think any, you know, masturbation jokes are fine, but like, you know, that's enough. You got 2 minutes worth, that's plenty. You don't really need to talk about it more, but especially the end of your 1 minute tonight, I was dubious, questioning where it was going, and then the final line about it, how you're gay, you're fucking yourself, is, it was a good, and he calmed me down, I was getting pretty excited, it was a good, you know, we laughed at the end, which in just a 1 minute set, that's pretty good.
We found out last week from Doug that he used to
Doug was on last week too.
This Doug.
This gentleman's this named Doug as well. We both named Doug, and we both masturbate.
But that Doug up there that's standing used to be on tour with Stevie Wonder. He was the stage...
A roadie.
Yes. Yep.
That's cool.
Stevie Wonder. Yes. How old are you, Doug? You mind us asking?
I'm sorry?
How old are you?
Like I said, my favorite number, 69.
69 years old?
Yes, sir.
Fuck. Wow, you do not look it. And also, I don't want to hear 69 jokes from someone who needs... 69.
No, here's what I'm going to tell you. Fucking A, good for you. And
yeah.
Just keep going up on stage and don't listen to anybody.
Tell roadie stories. Why in your first 2 minutes, why haven't you busted that out?
Because he doesn't need to. 2 minutes, man. That's nothing.
But it's special. It's what's special great. About him. Start with that.
No, you close with what's special, Doug.
Did you ever jerk off in front of Stevie Wonder because you knew you could get away with it?
Did you when he asked you to do something you didn't want to do, did you like flip him off and stuff? Like, did you take advantage of his blindness?
Did you really want to know? No, but did you ever make out with him and tell him you were an ingenue?
And he is all like, that's the best beard I've ever kissed.
You remember anything?
No, he's not into tall girls anyway.
All right, but let me just say to you, good for you, man. Good for you, you motherfucker.
What do you do for? I think that's
you're funny.
I think it's a neat career change.
Good. No, but I you should just go up and tell stories. And Doug's right. Tell them everything about your life, man. That's you've lived a life. Majority of comedians that I see now are really young, mm-hmm. and they don't know shit, and they suck, and they think they're smart. And you, my friend, have lived a life, and you have something to say. So go and say it. It's fucking fantastic. Now, mind you, if it's a young audience, they're not going to give a shit because they're douchebags. I think what you're getting from me is that young people can blow me. And the point, by the way, let me just go with that for 1 second. When I was...
That's right, young people, you can blow him. You are permitted to blow Jeff Garland, young people. ID's ready.
By the way, anyone who uses the term young people is just a douchebag. So take it from me, a douchebag. Fantastic. I enjoyed you.
I guess Jeff just decides when we're done with people. I'll keep it moving, Jeff. We're in good hands here.
Tony, I do trust you. I'm sorry. So stay there until Tony.
Okay, no, fuck it. Fuck it, I'm done. Doug Key, everybody. There we go. I like it.
69 years old. I can't.
Well, that's amazing. That's amazing. That's cool. That's so
interesting. It's interesting
cool.
that he's a liar. I know.
And he's got a lot of interesting.
And a former roadie.
You know what he loves, by the way? Pirates of the Caribbean, The Ride.
What was that reference?
It was a non sequitur, man.
It sure was.
The Ride. With it.
Right. He's wearing Ryan Gosling's jacket from Drive.
Oh, man. Another promo for Doug Loves Movies.
I love movies. I love them. I also love rides, though.
Put your hands together for your next comedian I just pulled out of the bucket. Grace Lusk.
I just moved to Venice Beach. Has anybody here been? Do you guys like Venice Beach? Give it up. Yeah? No? Maybe not? I love it. I love it there. The first time I worked on the boardwalk, I walked out and I immediately locked eyes with this guy who was sitting on a pile of trash. And he looked up at me and he was like, Moses? And that wasn't it, though. He goes, Moses? Jesus? Gandhi? They're all the same dude. I was like, whoa, you are profound, Oscar the Grouch. I gave him $1 bet to my sensei, and now I have a spiritual guide. We meet every Monday morning. I'm feeling very zen. Now, after that first interaction with him, I turned around, and I bumped into this lady, and she was wearing a huge backpack, and she just turned to me, and she was like, I got enough toilet paper for everybody! And I was like, holy shit, that is so much toilet paper. You are a valuable ally. Take my business card. Thank you.
Fuck yeah, Grace Lusk. Wow. Grace Lutz, I can tell you without a doubt that you're probably the only person that's come close to getting the West Hollywood Bear that didn't. I could feel like the, your finger moving.
Well, when she's too adorable.
Right about then. Yeah. I mean,
oh, like
wow.
It's like 3 seconds.
Like 2 seconds. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
It's usually just balls.
Yeah. Grace.
I wish I had that bear noise on the GOP debates. That'd be neat.
Yeah. How long you been doing stand-up?
A little over 2 years.
Where at?
Chicago. I actually just moved here.
Oh, my God. It just so happens to be that the king of Chicago is here right now, Jeff Garland. The king of Chicago. widely known as the king of Chicago. No.
Where in Chicago?
The south side. Beverly, 95th
Avenue. Oh, Beverly, look at you.
Yeah.
And where were you working? Is there like a lot of places to perform down there?
On the south side, I mostly did like stuff on the north side.
Where?
I ran like a monthly show at the Laugh Factory. And
you did?
Some bar shows.
All right. I like you.
Thank you.
You seem super pro to me, you know, in presentation, but for some reason, like the material wasn't landing until you did that funny voice.
Right.
Which was funny. And I think that the first part, like especially when you only have a minute, but even when you're just starting your set, asking people like, "Hey, what do you think of this Venice Beach? What do you know? What, have you been there? What do you think of it?" You ask like a series of questions.
A weird question.
Like, what if somebody's like, "I think it sucks"? Then you're like, "Well, now you're trying to get into your bit, and you got to deal with that, you know."
Yeah.
So it's like, other than that, everything was super pro, and I want to hear more.
How long have you been in LA?
Like 2 months.
2 months, and you got this Venice Beach thing going on, because you know everybody goes there first.
Yeah, I live there, so.
Oh, you live there?
Yeah.
Fancy. Not a lot of people start in Venice Beach.
Talk about what you know. She lives in Venice Beach. Other dude masturbates.
the material wasn't good because you made it up. What really?
No, I really, that was the, I,
no,
this,
hold on a second.
I
here.
Swear to you,
no,
I swear.
No, stop.
Fight.
Collaborate.
No, stop.
Listen.
Stop. Okay, let's go over what really happened.
Absolutely.
Okay, no.
Okay.
You go on the beach.
All right. I'm walking to the boardwalk.
You're walking to the boardwalk.
Hold on
and describe the man.
Okay, so he was a white guy, bearded.
Yeah.
It was like Doug on a bad day, you know? Like, sitting on a bunch of...
on a bad day.
No, the point I'm making is, I didn't believe your exchange. If it is true, you're not presenting it realistically.
Okay.
Just use your own voice. You're an interesting person.
Okay.
Yeah. I think she also like crammed it into a minute.
No,
instead
no,
of really
fuck that, Doc. Shut the fuck up. Do not defend her. Because I like her a lot. You're going to make it. You'll be fine.
Thanks.
No, you're going to be really good. You're good.
What did you really say when
you're
going to
make it after
that.
All.
No.
I didn't say anything. I was just like, okay.
That would have been funnier.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just letting you know.
I know. I'm that Oscar the Grouch shit. It hasn't been working.
Yeah.
So.
Well, you know why it doesn't work? Because it's not real, and I don't believe it for a millisecond.
Okay.
So I knew I was right that it wasn't real. So what you did was, he said that to you, and in your head, what did you think in that moment?
I said that kind of makes sense.
Then that's what you need to say. And then what did you do? You walked on, right?
And then I did encounter that lady with the backpack after that.
Okay, but I'm saying, and then what happened there?
She turned to me and she said,
okay,
she has enough.
What was your reaction? Was it really, that's a lot of toilet paper? No. What was your reaction to the toilet paper?
It was holy shit.
Holy shit, that's fucking weird.
That I reacted that way?
No, I'm saying no.
He's reacting that way.
The point I'm making is, when she told you she could have enough toilet paper for everybody, you didn't say, oh, that's a lot of toilet paper. You just thought, that's fucking nuts and funny and whatever.
Yeah.
So you should just go, that's fucking nuts, and walk on. Those are two little interesting tidbits of your day, as opposed to adding the fucking hack shit that you don't need. You know, I'm serious.
I don't need it. Yeah.
Because you're a genuinely funny person. You're an interesting person to listen to. So don't be afraid of what really happened.
Yeah.
It felt a little bit like comedy from another time. Like she was an excellent comedian like in the like 80s or 90s or something, didn't it?
It's almost like she's improv.
She was very, it was presented very professionally, like she said it a million times and it always kills.
Right.
But you're saying just make a little, add a little realism to it.
Crazy.
Not a little,
a lot,
real.
Be real.
Yeah.
I think that with stand-up, this is my take on it. that you find your groove, whether it's, are you a joke teller, or are you somebody that when you tell stories, or just yourself, your personality is funny. So you've got to find that out. You haven't been doing it long enough to know yet, but just figure what that is and follow that path, but don't be afraid to be genuine.
Yeah.
And if you are going to make stuff up and exaggerate truths, then do it after, in a longer set, when you've already done genuine stuff, because if you start with stuff like that, people are going to think everything you're saying is fake.
Okay. Right.
So after that, after we know that you didn't really give a dollar and go, thank you, Master Sensei, and bow in front of that guy that's sitting on a pile of trash.
The joke should be surprising, yet obvious.
Yeah.
Obvious that the audience recognizes it as a joke.
Right.
But you surprise them. That's how jokes, you know,
Grace,
work.
You could try that. You could tie those two people together. This the trash guy, who's the trash.
Would you shut up? You don't.
Let me speak my mind.
Don't tie those.
Let me speak my mind.
Told somebody last week that they should have a hat and glasses and a guitar, and it worked for them.
All right. Well, I'm going to talk anyways. I'm just going to keep talking.
It's okay.
So you can tie together like the ladies like. Trash for everybody, and you're like, well, that dude's got, or I got toilet paper for everybody, and that dude, well, you're like, that dude's got trash for everybody. Maybe you two could get together, collaborate, open up a dumpster.
Yeah, Jeff was wrong. That was totally worth the trouble.
Open up a dumpster kiosk. Well, you know what? I think I'm on guard because you've already said you didn't like me. I don't feel like I can get in a word ahead.
I like your music.
So I feel like I have a mind to speak, and I have lots of thoughts that are perfectly valid. I can articulate them very well.
By the way, I didn't say that wasn't valid.
And so I feel like I'm shut down.
Wrong.
So I want to be funny with you.
You can't. You're not allowed. I'm Jeff Garland.
Creator of Curb Your Enthusiasm,
you
bitches.
You're not allowed to, but you have a right to exist and a right to your opinion. And you can pretend, I'm not going to be here next week, so I'm thrilled that you are.
Jeff, when you started off, did you have something that it took you a while to find your voice? Because I think that's something like new people always have, like this act almost, like instead of being yourself.
No, I had...
Jeff has been pure honesty from day one. For better or worse.
By the way, I'm...
For better or worse, right? Like, in some ways, that can hurt you a little bit.
When I first started, my whole thing was about television, cartoon characters. It was bullshit. And cartoon characters fucking... And I would kill. Fuck did I kill. And then one night, I threw out my whole act and said, I'm only going to talk about what I care about and through who I am. And I bombed for a number of years, which was totally cool, you know?
What did Adam West's Batman think of your act?
He found it rather confusing. I mean, with Chief O'Hara, Aunt Harriet before it's too late.
What if Adam West's Batman?
He knows that was like one of the early things that I did was Adam West Batman.
Oh, because Adam West kills me.
You know what Doug does now is one of the best Bane impressions. Have you ever heard his Bane?
And when you say one of the best, it's probably in the top 12.
Well, I mean,
in the world.
That's normally when you would just do the Bane impression, Doug. But
like a professional, I just jump in and do it like he did when I told him to do his.
Yeah.
Your performance needs to come out of the shadows.
Good advice from me. Are you doing the new Batman?
Talk to Christian Bale.
Batman. So make a phony phone call to me.
Okay.
Ring, ring.
Hello. Hello, Batman. Yes. But listen to me.
Oh, Christian Bale will be like,
yes. Who is this? Why is this on the phone? That's no matter what role he plays.
Well, yeah, he does that a lot.
Seriously. You're good.
Seriously. Great job.
Were you born in Chicago?
Yeah.
Go Bears, although we suck this year.
Yes.
But the point being is,
Blues Brothers.
I like you, and we'll work together someday.
Yeah.
I promise
and,
you
and Grace, he's absolutely right. Go more real. Tell the truth so that people don't think you're bullshit.
Tell the truth!
Because you have a likable head, and that's going to work out great for you. I mean, Jeff Garland already wants to work with you. So.
No, I think you're totally right. I think I'm jumping to, like, an act out when I should just be living in the moment first.
Yes.
And then do an act out.
And also just talking
about you.
And while doing act outs or not, just talking about real honest, more honest shit.
I bet you you're a good actress too.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm just guessing. But no, I meant I'm just guessing, but I that's my guess. But yeah, you're good for you.
There she goes, everybody. Grace Lux.
Go get it.
Grace Lux. She's on Twitter at Grace Lux. L-U-S-K.
And for me, the slide, can I just tell you something? No fucking around. That is the most beautiful thing to hear in between performers, a little slide guitar, and you do a nice job with it. So I'm positive too. But she didn't really need that combo, the two characters. What was that? Do what you know, slide. By the way, I had a guitar lesson before I came here. I can't slide. That's all I'm saying.
Was her name Grace? Is that what you said, Grace?
Yeah.
There's an amazing restaurant in Chicago called Grace.
There's a street called Grace by Wrigley Field.
Grace trivia! So much fun!
Amazing. I pulled another name out of the bucket, everybody. This looks like a new one. Put your hands together for Nia DeBose.
I don't believe in bikini waxing. Let's just jump into that. I don't think you should have to wax your pussy, folks. I don't. To me, that seems like something I would pay to have done to an enemy. You know what I'm saying? Like, I meet with a guy in like the back alley. I'm like, hey, listen, you see that bitch over there by the bar? I want you to get that bitch. To put some hot wax on her pussy. I'm just saying, you get an edge up and a bald fade. You'd be grateful for the hairy pussy that you get. That's all. I'm Nia DeBose. That's my time.
There you go.
Yeah.
Was that Buddy Holly for like a second?
Yeah, it was
Peggy Sue for a second. Hey, seriously.
Yes.
Okay, that was really funny. So here's what I recommend, just based on that, and you can use it towards anything else you want. Don't come out and go right into the pussy references, but the idea... No. That's not what I'm saying. It was really funny when you told the person to go pour hot wax on her pussy in that moment. But prior to that, let that... See, that's the surprise aspect, you saying that. But if you already say pussy up front, hot wax on the pussy, it takes away from that. Do you know what I mean? So use it when you have to. Don't overdo the pussy is all I'm saying.
I enjoyed all the pussy.
Right.
See, I thought it was continuously funny that she kept saying pussy.
Because you're high.
No, it's true. The waxing is all that she needs to say. Save the pussy for the
pussy. So it's like, I'm not anti-pussy saying that shit. But when you say stuff too much, especially early on, the minute you hit the stage, it sort of numbs you, the audience, immediately.
Much like a pussy waxing.
No, yeah. that would make, I think, more than
that. That makes you quite alert.
Yeah.
Have you had your
sleep through a pussy waxing?
Doug, you had your pussy wax before?
No, but I see it all the time depicted in comedy programs.
Yeah. You know that my
should be happening in dramas.
Pussy wax Richards?
Really? You were pussy wax?
Your pussy's nerve endings, that's all I'm saying.
Pussy wax Richards.
Destroy. Yeah.
So what do you do down there?
I just lock it, so I've got...
Lock it?
Holy shit. I call it the Stevie Wonder. That's
don't fucking around it. You made me laugh hard. That was really hard. I've never heard that before. It's a good premise. That's funny.
Thank you.
Yeah, fuck, man. The girl who I liked before you, I didn't laugh hard. Thought she was great and she's going to do great things. I think you could too.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Awesome. Why is everybody so upset about waterboarding when pussy waxing's happening?
There you go.
I
wonder though if like pussy waxing brings you nightmares.
And well, the P in PTSD stands for
pussy traumas.
Nia, how long are you from LA?
No, I'm from Houston. Actually, I just saw you at whatever fest in Houston.
Oh, nice. Yeah, Houston's comedy crowds are great. You probably have a great time doing shows.
You live here or are you just visiting?
I live here.
How long have you lived here?
Since July.
Oh, wow. What
since
part
July.
Of town?
Like Little Armenia.
Ooh, Little Armenia.
What's your social?
1, 2, 3.
Is this your first dealing with Armenians?
No, I've actually never really met any Armenians.
So how's that culture shock for you?
It's really not, because it's by the Scientology center. They don't... That's way more shocking than...
If you go in.
Yeah, I won't.
Then it's not that shocking. Yeah. It's just a building with a word Scientology.
No, they walk, them through the neighborhood, and they make them touch stuff.
And then they take you to a room. And
did you know going clear is just another expression for pussy waxing?
That
will not be topped tonight. You have hit number one for the night.
Nia, what do you do for work?
I drive for Uber.
That's a great thing for comedians to do.
Do you ever talk about it?
No, not really. Because before I moved here, my day job in Houston was I drove a bus.
Whoa. You talk about that at all?
No, Jesus Christ.
You should talk about that time you had to keep it up over 55.
That was quite an adventure.
It's amazing, as
spoke earlier in terms of Bob being, you need to be talking about the bus.
Had a guy have a drug overdose on my bus once.
Well, then that's a story.
Hilarious.
By the way, it might be.
I hope when he died and you threw him under the bus and went on your own. Because the expression thrown under the bus is never about really being thrown under a bus. Ever.
I think what's amazing about you driving the bus is how far we've come since Rosa Parks. You know what I mean?
All the way.
It's like you're in the best seat now.
I'm in the front of the bus.
And that was the most cushy.
Do you miss the bus?
Sometimes it has the beads on the back. It's very comfortable.
Those actually are pretty comfortable.
Right?
Yeah.
Have a kiss on your back. You can do some math.
Bend in the middle. It's nice. I don't miss it, though. I would never go back. No.
Was it a... Go ahead, Jeff.
No, I just imagine that there were people that rode your bus regulars that you could talk about.
Yes. There were.
But so what the fuck are you doing?
Because I got other shit to fucking talk about.
Then you're good.
You loved the minute that she did.
Yeah, I did.
And now she's got another minute or more about bus driving.
But she's not doing the bus, dude.
She can't. The bus is too big a story to do in a minute.
No, but she
pussy waxing. Bam. Oh. Say it three times. Meow. You're done.
The point is, what are you doing right now?
That's for sure.
That's not actually for sure. You don't know that. No, you don't, because maybe when you put on your pants, one broke loose, and then the air conditioning went to Doug's mouth. But here's the thing.
And now we are one.
That's all it takes, by the way. One pussy air, boom. They think the same. That's a great science fiction show. I'm going to pitch it. If someone's pubic hair gets loose, and then if it enters the mouth of another person, you share a brain.
Definitely pitch it
out the window.
You get anything you want.
Nia, what do you like to do for fun? What's like? What are some of your hobbies or something?
My hobbies.
Other than stand-up comedy.
Oh, other than stand-up. Okay, well then that's it. No, I like to do a lot of. I like read a lot.
It's good.
I used to really be into like weightlifting and MMA, so now I just kind of spectate. So I like to watch a lot of the fights.
Mm-hmm. But you wanted to participate before.
Yeah, I used to do a lot of training.
I'm just telling you right now, I'm not going to fuck with you.
No, that's okay. Yeah.
And what I was going to say is, which I was interrupted more by the high guy than you. Someone said you talk about the bus.
I don't interrupt you ever.
By the way, truly, Doug, yes. You don't.
I keep my place.
No, I didn't. In our long-term relationship, you do not interrupt me. I, on the other hand, am a constant interruption, and I know that. But that's, at least we're clear.
Tell the lady your great information you have for her.
Well, here's the information. Someone asked you if you talk about the bus, and you were like, very adamantly, no. So that's all I'm saying. Add that to your repertoire with the other shit.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, like the regulars, or what we got. But I don't know what the fuck it is. I didn't drive the bus. But you do, and most people don't drive a bus.
And make it clearly in the past, too, because, like, you're a professional comedian now, so, like, that's what people want from you. But, like, yeah, I used to have to drive a bus.
Now,
boom, you're in.
Now you have a Prius, right?
No.
Oh, what are you Ubering with?
An Impala.
Wow. Very rarely get an Impala. I
do get it.
But she still clips bike riders on the regular.
You Uber a lot, Jeff?
Not as much. When I'm in New York, I do a lot. But I go for the most expensive one because I'm rich.
Yeah. I feel like you...
So you would not get my Impala.
I would not get Uber X, no.
I feel like you're the type of guy that also doesn't automatically give drivers 5 stars. I feel like you really...
No, unless they're an asshole, it's 5 stars. And my son, who uses my account, I'm down to 4.7. I don't like that.
Oh, your son's bringing your rating down? Because the drivers are giving him a bad rating?
I was a 5.
Is he using Uber X or is he using like a...
He's using all sorts of Uber shit.
You know why they do that? It's because it's when you fart in the back seat.
No, it's actually... Truth is, he's a kid, he doesn't know any better, but I know it's because of drunks for the most part.
Yes.
Yeah, I know. He doesn't drink, but you know.
Sometimes I'll pick Uber Black and the driver's white. It bums me out. Trying to give back to a segment of society.
He's great at closing out a segment. Yeah. Doug Benson just closed that out beautifully.
I love that. Nia, craziest thing you've ever seen in your Uber?
Nothing. That's pretty fun.
Do you go late nights ever?
No, I don't do late nights.
You do the day?
Yeah, I do during the day. Okay. Now the bus, that's some shit.
The bus you did late night. That was a city bus in Houston.
I did the late shift, and I picked up all the prostitutes and crackheads.
So all I'm saying is, what the fuck are you not talking about?
That
for?
I'm saying, man, all this bitch is shitting in the bus.
By the way, have you ever seen or heard of Richard Pryor?
No, is he new?
No. I think for a rare time, I'm so bad at sarcasm. Like I never do sarcasm, that when I do it, it seems so sincere. No, the point being is, he talked about some ugly ass shit and made it funny, which you could do too.
I guess because I haven't found a way to make that funny because that was my day job.
Well, I don't do, by the way. Let's talk about, I have an area that I don't do because I can't make it funny, and that's politics. I never talk about what I think about politics because I just start getting angry and I turn into Soapbox Johnson. So I avoid it. So you'll figure it out. But you're also at a point where that might be a possibility. Like, I know at this point in my career that I'm not doing politics. I'm not going to be a political comedian. You don't know what you are. You should be experimenting with everything.
Okay.
Yeah, that's
I
all.
I will.
All right, good.
Do you ever talk about politics?
Why do you keep
Trump needs his pussy wax
he does.
Head.
Pussy on top of his fucking head.
She said the pussy on his head. Donald Trump.
Oh, your lip shot. No? Okay.
Nia DeBose. So nice to meet you.
Yay!
She's on Twitter. Nia DeBose. N-A-D-E-B-O-S-E.
By the way,
can I get another drink real quick?
Yeah, what kind of drink do you want?
I don't care, I just want it real quick.
Well, you just have to say it. if you want us to bring you one of everything?
Bring me one of each. He knows what I want. He knows
okay,
what I want.
There you go. I'll take one too, Josh.
By the
one
way,
of mine.
Can I also say that Josh knows. I'm off all social media except for Instagram.
Oh, okay. Oh, Jeff's off social media, you guys. Alert the regular media.
This is one of the people that has gotten pulled out of the bucket quite a few times. He literally.
Can I say my thing?
Yeah, go ahead, Jeff.
Jeff Garland on Instagram.
That's it? Just Jeff Garland?
Jeff Garland on Instagram?
But I'm verified.
Oh, okay.
Keep going.
He's legit on Instagram, you guys.
And you take great pictures.
I am a photographer,
that's
yes.
Right.
That's what I do with my spare time.
You know who else takes
that
pictures?
And I run a lotion shop.
And I've also heard that you were... Been maybe getting into the chocolate business, is this right?
Oh, it's Chocolatier.
Yes.
That's a funny name.
Every time I hear the word chocolatier, I think of you.
Why not?
This guy has been pulled out of the bucket so many times because Asians are so lucky. And every single time it seems like he kills. He has a very funny style. We're always happy to pull him out of the bucket. Put your hands together for the one and only Tam Pham.
I'm sick, so I'm covering up the mic. I'm used to being the weird guy. I grew up in Mexico. I'm sorry, the Valley. I keep making...
Sorry.
I keep making that mistake because I have eyes. It was hard. I never fit in, especially like when I was 9, because that was the year where my mom thought it was a good idea to give me a perm. Now, if you think that my school full of Latinos was making fun of me a lot for being Asian with big ears, imagine being Asian with a Jew fro. They called me the Diary of Japan Frank.
His own personal story, but with solid jokes, Jeff. What could you possibly
Tam
critique
Fam,
about that?
How do you, Tam Fam, how much do you hate black people that you would put the paper towel on?
That's what I was thinking. I was doing.
He said, and even if he was lying, it was very eloquent, that he was sick and that's why he was doing
well,
it.
Well, first of all,
and
can I just
thoughtful,
say, well,
even if he's full of shit, it was thoughtful.
Yeah, well, you know, to be more thoughtful is if you're really sick, stick to your culture and wear one of those weird surgical masks that your grandparents wear every flight that I'm on around this country. I'm always next to some Asian in a surgical mask. And by the looks of your ears, the thing would never come off. So it would probably stay on permanently for life.
You know what's really cool is, first off,
is that why they're all wearing those? To keep us from getting sick? That's
yeah.
So sweet.
Is that true?
That's what he's saying, yeah.
Mostly.
They're mostly because it doesn't work the other way around, supposedly. So I always laugh at them, like, what are you doing? But they're trying to keep
they're
me from getting sick? That's so sweet. I'm going to run over and pull that mask off and kiss them on the mouth.
What are you sick with, Tam Fam? Bird flu? Whoops. All right.
Really too soon for the bird flu jokes, guys?
No, that's right. You told me you want to keep it funny and not so serious.
Whoa, geez, Jeff, really pulling the wizard out of the curtain there.
No, I just, because I really have a thought. He's funny, and you have a face of someone who should be doing comedy, and that's not meant as a, like, insult, but you look like, oh, that guy, like, you're funny.
He's fun.
Yeah.
He's a fun guy.
Point being is, this style is not exactly right for you, the 1 minute type situation. I imagine if things are slower, you're pretty fucking good.
I thought he killed it with just 1 minute.
No, I'm not saying that he was bad, but I'm saying you're probably better when, you know, you're, not that anyone wouldn't be better. What the fuck is this format?
Well, they have to save time for what you just did, so that's why the comedians don't get to talk very well. But, you already said that he's a favorite around here. This is my first time seeing you, right? I've never been in this seat before when you're on, and I thought that was, you're a professional comic in my mind.
Yeah, it was fun. You're obviously working hard. You're going out when you're sick.
You're spreading your disease everywhere you go.
How long have you been stand up for, Tam Fam?
A year and a half.
Doing very good.
Yeah, you're doing very good.
Yeah, really good.
That's the thing about...
I'm jealous of how good you're doing.
You've been getting
a year and a half is pretty fast to be this good.
Yeah.
Have you been getting up a lot?
Just thinking about it.
No, I was much better. You know me, like a weekend, I passed out. That was fucking great. But
he already had the Adam West closer about a year and a half ago.
By the way,
that's
I had
strong.
Adam West the first time.
Day one.
But, you know, it's like everyone.
Day one. I.
Is that another move?
Your pain, man. No, hey, seriously, it's like it just takes so much time and you just got to keep going up on stage and doing it. And it's like some nights you'll come off and you feel like, I know nothing. And you don't. And sometimes you come off and you go, I'm great. And you're not. It's like it's just a constant process. But you're really good. And good luck to you.
Tam Fam, tell us something else about you other than that you do stand-up. Like, what do you like to do for fun? You ever drive a bus or anything like that?
Nah.
Ever get your pussy waxed? You don't have to answer that. I was just fucking around.
I can answer Tony's real question.
What do you do for fun?
I tend to only do things once. Like I went to a gun range once. I went skydiving once. I went to Europe once.
Hey, you get all out of all those alive that one time. Why bother to take any chances?
What was skydiving?
But those are all probably comedic stories that you're working on, right?
Eventually, I'm going to try.
What
to
do you do more than once?
Just this, really.
Just this?
Yeah.
Right. Skydiving
is. So I take it you're not a virgin, but one time.
Right. How was skydiving?
Did you do it with Indiana Jones?
Wow, are you calling him Short Round?
You know, skydiving as an Asian is interesting because they're the only race whose eyes don't change while skydiving. If you picture that one, guys, it's more of a picture it joke than anything else.
And as if I can give advice to young comics, do as many picture it jokes as you can. Because audiences grab hold and they don't let go.
It's a podcast. Yes. It's a podcast.
That's true.
So do you carry that same paper towel around with you everywhere?
No, I just pulled this one from that.
Yeah, you got it fresh, just for us.
But you got it from the bathroom?
Yeah.
You know, it's covered with more disease probably than you.
I really thought he was going to do like the old joke of like wiping off the mic and then saying something about, I don't know where the other comics have been or whatever. Right. Yeah. But he's really just trying to keep people from getting sick.
I like him because he's very thoughtful and he's funny. He's a good man. Mm-hmm. Most people are dicks, and look at you.
What do you do for work?
You're not remotely a dick. No, seriously, you're not remotely a dick. I can tell. You're a good man. You're what we Jews call a mensch. You're clearly a mensch. And the world's your oyster, and just keep going.
What do Asians call him?
Jeff?
Yeah. Most of my interactions,
smart like that.
Most of my interactions with anyone of another culture, they call me by my name. Nothing, and no unusual pronunciation. It's just my name.
And some of them say, Hey. Some of
Hefe, actually, the only person who ever said Hefe that I heard was a white woman who thought it was interesting to call me Hefe.
Was it Fran Drescher?
No, it was the the driver on my TV show. All right.
See, sometimes truth isn't funny.
By the way, that's totally true.
Tam Fam, what do you do for work?
I work as an extra. Few days a week.
In motion pictures and television?
Oh yeah?
That's how I got my start in the biz.
Are you ever
watching? Oh, you used to tell stories about being an extra.
Oh, the stories I would tell.
I do
how
remember.
We'd line up for lunch.
She was your closer.
You work on anything cool? Like you ever like Dr. Ken stand-in or anything like that?
Do you ever see the old Iron Patriot, comic patriot, Jeff whatever his name is, Crabtree?
I don't know what he looks like outside the wacky costume.
Oh, yeah, that's true. You haven't seen him outside the costume. But yeah. He does extra work, too.
But what's like a movie or TV show we know that you were an extra in?
A bunch of them. Scandal.
Ooh, Scandal. Mm.
Isn't being an extra in a TV show like that so much fun that you just sit around for hours?
Did you find it scandalous?
No.
Like I said, sometimes the truth is funny.
You said, "Did you get any pussy?"
Yeah.
You were about to say, "Literally, did you get any pussy being an extra on Scandal?"
Yeah.
No one gets more pussy than the young people.
Did you impregnate Kerry Washington? Is that your baby?
When's the last time you got laid, Tam Fam?
Don't do that, Dan.
What kind of question is that?
Show? What are we talking about?
I know, but it's none of our business. Do you enjoy
sex? Yeah, it is. Tam Fam, when's the last time you got laid?
No, Tam Fam, don't tell us. Here's what I want you to do, Tam Fam. I want you to leave the stage with dignity.
That's not how it's... How do you know it wasn't...
Let's go down the table.
How do you know he didn't get sick eating some bad pussy, Jeff?
Eating some bad pussy? Like it grows somewhere?
Did you notice the expiration date on that pussy?
It was bad.
No, but Tam Fam.
General, no.
Your lovemaking, no one's business. It's not. You enjoy it, obviously.
I can't wait
really
until next week.
Wait, you don't really enjoy it?
Not really.
Whoa. Now
thank
then,
you.
Now the door has been opened.
The door was open before, Jeff. You
now,
closed it.
Not when was the last time you got
somehow went. Tony sensed you had a weird sex life. And,
yeah, how can
now
you
here
guess
we
that?
Are.
Do you like mirth? No. So you don't like sex. Do you like robotics? Generally, most people who don't enjoy sex are big fans of robotics. That's what I find. Do you collect pottery from around the world?
You
that
will.
Be fun. You will. Tony's seen it happen before.
Tam Fam, another great set. Good to see you again. Go get healthy. What was that, Pat? Were you surprised about something there? You just gave me a, what was that? That look there at the end. Nothing?
Oh, that was why. Why does he not like sex?
That's why I want to know why he doesn't like the puss.
But guess what? I know the answer, and it's none of our business.
Oh, wow. Jeff obviously hooking up with Tam Fam on this.
He has the most beautiful...
You know, he's prioritizing, and right now he's doing a good job writing jokes.
Jeff, a cool...
I concur.
You know what I mean? Some guys don't go chase after the
pussy. A cool thing that happens on this show is... there's two young ladies that go up that write and perform a brand new
We're at that part?
Every single
week.
Are
these the ones I saw before a long time ago?
Actually, those ones now
they
tour
graduated.
Around the country, and they go down. They go up in the original room downstairs on Mondays, and we have two new regulars.
Okay.
And so every week, these two write and perform. They're under the pressure of having to write and perform a brand new minute every single week, which is really tough. And then we talk to them about anything at all, just like we've talked to everybody else here tonight. So...
Do you understand how this works, Jeff?
No, yeah, he does.
He just explained it.
He sure did.
And, yeah.
Okay.
So I'm going to bring up your first regular. She's been on the show for a few months now. She started brand new with us, known for her extreme nervousness and knack for apologizing on stage. Here she is tonight with a new minute. Put your hands together for Melissa Esslinger.
Why did the turtle cross the road? To get to the Shell station. I wrote that when I was 8, and that's adorable. I saw Star Wars this weekend, and while I was killing time in the lobby, there was this guy talking very loudly on his phone about how he felt about the movie. And without any thought or shame, I turned to him and said, "Ah!" But it's LA, so he just ignored me. I don't like to poop in public places. So, but like sometimes you have to. So, I had to make up this song that I sing to myself so I can go. I'm like, I know you really don't want to poop here. But sometimes. Oh, shit.
Shit, get it?
But you gotta do. Oh, fuck you guys. Oh my god. You gotta do what you gotta do, and right now you gotta poop. That's what I say to myself. So I can poop.
There you go. Another new minute. Marissa Esslinger. Knock it out.
I finished your song. I finished your song. All right, you're done pooping. Time to wipe. Now I'm going to the sink, gonna soap up my hands. I'm gonna go see something. I'm at a public place. I'm going home.
See, his point is it never gets easy.
You just gotta keep trying stuff.
This is fun. What do you, Doug?
Opened stronger than she closed tonight, but she's also like, the difference in the shaking is unbelievable. Like, you don't shake it anymore. But what about, do you have to wear your glasses?
Well, I hurt my eye. I was taking a break from the contacts.
Oh, okay.
But eventually, because you
You fiddle with them
a lot. Yeah, I don't like them.
Yeah, yeah. So it's like it's another affect that you've picked up instead of shaking. But I just think you're just fun, and you know, especially the first part. I don't know about the poop song.
Yeah, the way that your likability is your biggest trademark, without a doubt. And you can do stuff like that first joke. You know, you could just be adorable and talk about it and move on and kill with it because. You can do that because it feels genuine. It felt like you wrote it when you were 8, and had you said anything else, it probably wouldn't have worked. But that type of honesty and openness with yourself, and it feels honest. So there you go. There's good jokes peppered in there. Jeff Garland, initial thoughts. First time seeing Melissa Esslinger, who has to write and perform a new minute every week.
As someone who hasn't written a new minute in ever, I don't have an act. See, so therefore, I just go up and I start talking,
So every time I actually go on stage, it's a new minute, unless you're working with me on something, you know? So I think you're a big bowl of adorable, and you seem funny, and you seem super intelligent, and I can tell you're a good writer, and you're I like everything about you. Is that enough?
Yeah, that's great.
Yeah, so I would just, and by the way, why don't you just go up one night and say how much you hate your glasses and see where it takes you.
Okay.
That's all.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. You might shake a little more because you don't know where you're going.
Yeah.
But you might come up with something that'll make you go, fuck, I gotta always wear my glasses. And the glasses, I don't know you without glasses. And you're fine with glasses.
Well, thank you.
I like her a lot. Yeah, go.
What did you think of the new Star Wars movie? You were excited about it.
Yeah.
It's really
I don't
good.
Want to ruin anything.
I'm just
anybody.
A little confused. Was the guy like giving spoilers out when he was talking, or just
who
like,
was giving spoilers?
He the wasn't guy giving in the spoilers. Although some kids I was sitting next to before that were, but I tuned it out quick enough. But the guy in the lobby, he was just like giving his opinion, and I thought he was being a dick already. So I was like,
you really did that to him?
No. Well, I did go, not that loud. I wasn't that loud,
so
but I did kind of, and I.
I thought you were gonna when you said the thing about when somebody's talking about Star Wars and then you immediately went into having to go to the bathroom. I thought that the punchline was gonna be, and when I go to the bathroom, the only way I can do it is if I go and you do the same thing again.
Well,
like, you don't want to hear your own shit that you're taking.
Well, I didn't really do it in those.
No spoilers on my bowel movement, please.
That's good. Well, and actually, I did it more for myself. Like, I literally didn't want to hear what he was saying, so I was like,
yeah.
You know what I would have done in that situation? I would have, if I was with you and we're going to see Star Wars and we saw him, to make you laugh, I would have gone over, put my hands in my ears and yelled, and danced at the same time. And he would have had to have noticed me.
When you say pooping in public places, what kind of places are we talking about?
You're out and about and you gotta go.
Like in a restroom?
Yeah. Yes.
By the way, I know a lot of. Hold on a second. I know a
lot. You don't
lot
like going in restrooms?
Two things I can do is poop pretty much anywhere and take a nap almost anywhere. I know that about myself, but I know a
That's
lot.
That's
because
you
of
have narc poopalepsy.
Well, we
Dog,
know.
I told you don't make fun of.
Don't make fun of my narc poopalepsy. I can shit or sleep anywhere. It's
hold
a problem.
On. That's my stage name. Please welcome narc poopalepsy. A lot of people have that problem. I know a lot of people. You know, you guys are just not sensitive enough to people.
That's true.
Time,
that's a problem.
That's a problem.
Yeah. It's a very negative program we do here.
Yeah, you're just being a little too...
When I'm on. Right, Brian? Brian's not even saying anything because Jeff was so mean to him earlier.
But he did deserve it. What the fuck was he talking about? What the fuck does this guy talk about? Except it's like a duck. You're lovely.
Well, thank you.
All right, continue that.
Melissa Esslinger, everybody.
Melissa!
One of the hardest jobs in showbiz.
I'm never doing this show again.
I bet.
I don't want to do it anymore.
Are you quitting the show right now?
No, I'll finish it out, but
we're
not coming back.
We're almost there, Jeff. Thank you.
I've had it with this shit.
Why don't you like him? What's the problem?
Because I never wanted to be a judge on a
it's
fucking
not a judge.
Last douchebag standing.
You're just supposed
standing
to help him out.
It's not a douchebag standing.
I don't like
that. Nobody
like
wins.
Criticism.
Nobody loses.
See, that's
it's just advice.
When I said keep it light, don't be too serious. It's because it's not last comic standing.
But
I'm
just
having some laughs.
Here's the thing. I don't take myself seriously, but I take what I do seriously. And this shit's what I do, so I take it very serious when talking to them. And I want to be encouraging to people, you know, when they need... Because these people are all really... I'm actually impressed.
Yeah.
Because I really love stopping people who suck. And no, they just get in the way of everyone. They get in the way of your enjoyment. They don't get in the way of my stage time. I go up when I want. But the point being is that, you know... All right, who's next?
Let's do it. Our final regular. This is her second week. Second week as a regular.
Second week, wow.
Her first and only time ever up in front of Jeff Garlin. Because you just retired from the show after this. This is definitely her.
This
the
is your last time
see.
Together, so enjoy it.
By the way, unless I take a personal interest in her career, or the girl from Chicago, like is like your regular, I'm not coming back.
Okay.
All right. Back for the Chicago girl if she becomes a regular.
I think you might like this other regular who we have. This is her second week ever being a regular on the show. Her third time ever on the show. put your hands together for. It's the stylings of Vanessa Johnston.
I feel like that's a lot of pressure. Jeff, hi.
Hi, Vanessa.
Hi, hello. I'm kind of sick of people seeing racial stereotypes instead of individual people. Like, some of the best dancers in the world are white. Some of the best mathematicians in the world are black. Unfortunately, they're Asians. There are no Asian NASCAR drivers. So that one might be true. There's been like one guy, his name's Hideo Fukuyama. His best race, he placed 33rd. But that was only because there was an accident on the track which tied up all the white, black, and Hispanic drivers so that he was able to move up from 66. And Hideo was the cause of that accident. So, you guys don't think like Tokyo Drift was invented on purpose? No. No. Okay.
Exactly a minute. Vanessa Johnston.
I love a Tokyo Drift reference.
You loved it, right?
Love it, yeah.
It depends. Like, that room, like, there's people that are car people and they get it, and the people, like, sometimes people are not car people, they, nobody gets it.
Right. And sometimes there's Asians in the audience, like,
and they love it. Asians love it.
Do you think that she could, like, somehow shorten the math part of that joke where she's like, you know, 33 and then 66? It could be something, like, quicker.
More punchy.
But, yeah.
I didn't hear a word you said.
Why is that, Jeff? What happened?
I don't know anything about race car driving, and she's pretty.
Yeah. She just blanked out.
I just looked at her like, wow, she's really pretty, and I don't care about race car driving. That was my inner monologue. Oh, look at her. Good for you.
I was going to talk about going down on girls, but I figured that wasn't your, like, steez.
Start up a new minute.
There we go. It's Vanessa Johnston, everybody, with another brand new minute. Taking next week off and doing this minute right now.
Could you do a minute on that right now?
No, that's what I was going to do originally.
Do it!
Do it.
Really? Okay.
Yeah.
Vanessa Johnston!
So, I date women and men, unfortunately. And I just started going down on girls. And it's not going as well as I expected. Like, here's the thing. I'm a girl. She's a girl. Like, you should know how to do yourself. And everyone thinks this. Like, every guy in this room, even if they're not gay, they're like, but if I was gay, I would suck the meanest dick. Hands down. And it's so cliche, but the clit is hard to find. And, like, girls, like, we think it's easy. And that's because we have, like, huge vibrators, like the size of Jupiter. And then it just vibrates our entire lower body. Like, you can't fuck it up, is my point. And the worst part is, like, even if you do find it, you don't know if you're doing it right because girls are liars. They come.
57 seconds. Double kill Vanessa Johnston. Jeff Garland, what do you think about that one?
I heard everything you said. And I thought it was good. You were talking about what you gave a shit about at the moment. And it was a lot more interesting than the race car stuff. I mean, it's not titillating to me, you know what I mean? By the way, it's titillating, but it's not titillating. I'm not, you know, but the point being is, what was interesting was that you were really passionate talking about it, and it was interesting. And there you go, so.
When I go down on a Japanese woman, I call it the Tokyo Drift. But yeah, that was fun. And but I thought both minutes had good parts.
Like, but you're, by the way, even if let's just also talk about that. Even if you're a gay man or whatever, someone talking about their sexuality in terms of going down on someone, if they make it remotely interesting, it's very interesting.
Oh yeah,
it's a good topic.
Yeah.
It's a really good topic.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
More than like
you know, yeah, racist shit.
And just with anything,
it's like
going down on somebody so much better than racist shit.
It is.
I really agree.
That's a basic lesson in stand-up comedy. Mm-hmm. If you, I don't find anything about, for the most part, it all bores me. The thing about different types of people and this and that shit.
Right.
That just, to me, that it's been done so much over the years. That it's just like, it's a big bowl of who gives a shit.
People will always
want to know. You're dating women and men. There's so many compare and contrast festivals you can go with. And going down on women and having that attitude, it should work. Because that anyone, if a man would know. I thought it was all smart and good, considering you're talking about going. That's the thing, too. Like when she was talking about the pussy waxing earlier. Mm-hmm. It's not, shocking is bullshit. But when you're really talking about something that you're living through, or her saying that it's something you do to somebody, that's really funny, you know? So I dug it. And it's your second week. Good luck to you. I'm not going to take an interest, though.
Okay.
No, I'll tell you why. I'm an old married man, and look at you. And so really, it does me no good to tell my wife, oh, I've taken
my wife. What is that?
That's what's his name?
It's a popular thing that people do.
Yeah, by the way, I'm not gonna. Point being is, I'm not taking an interest, but I wish you great luck, and hopefully someday we do work together, and I'll be nice. I'll have some sort of an interest, but it won't be too much. It won't be too much. It's just not. I've learned at this point. I've been doing this for 33 years, and I'm 53 years old. There are certain things to avoid. Spending a lot of time with you would be one of those. It's just not good for me in any way. I'm sure you're lovely. Not that you asked me.
Have you heard this one? Honesty is cruelty. Just shut up already.
I
don't take an interest in you.
Okay.
No, you're too beautiful to live.
Never said that.
I hope you get cancer. It's the subtext, Jeff.
There was no subtext at that time. But Doug, why don't you take it personally? You both can go get high. And,
do you smoke weed? She doesn't even smoke weed.
Yes, and she had done.
Did you see how excited I got at that opportunity?
By the way, that's what you. Is that your only line of offering something to women? You can hide.
Oh, good. Yeah, it turns out, Jeff, that's the only line I need, really, at this point. I mean, not with her, obviously, but.
You keep throwing what
she likes
doing
the ladies.
Vanessa, what's your Twitter handle?
Vanessa John Stew.
How do you spell the John Stew? J O H N S T.
Oh, John Stew.
My name was taken.
And does anyone here who came went up have an Instagram account?
That's what I'm like, an Instagram person. Are you an Instagram person?
Yes, Jeff Garland.
I'm all about the visuals.
Yeah, visuals.
I can see how this relationship's going to start. Instagram direct message.
Dick. By the way, what is your Instagram?
Vanessa V. Johnston.
Vanessa V. Johnson or just
Johnston with a T.
Vanessa V. Johnston.
Every dude in the room just memorized her Instagram.
And by the way, listeners, for taking a chance, they're going.
And
there.
I'll tell you what, one of the coolest all-time moves by any regular in week two by busting out 2 minutes. Congratulations, Vanessa Johnston.
Yeah, great job.
We did it. That's the show. Pat Reagan's at Patty Reagan on Twitter. Anything else you want to promote, Pat?
I was just on Adam Devine's house party, so look for it.
Oh, that's great. You shot that in Hawaii. That's so fucking awesome. Josh Martin's at Josh Martin. Melissa Esslinger is Melissa Esslinger. Doug Benson's at Doug Benson. Mm-hmm. Check out Doug Loves Movies. All the great things going on over there. His special on Netflix. The one and only, my favorite person in the world, Jeff Garland. Curb Your Enthusiasm. Meet the Goldbergs.
Now just call the Goldbergs. The Goldbergs, ABC. I'm rich and I'm very successful. I drive a Tesla. Please support all those things by watching.
I'm trying to get one more drink right before the show ends.
Texas,
one more free drink.
Texas, it's this Saturday and Sunday, and Caroline's on Broadway. The first weekend.
I'll be napping
that's
over
awesome.
The holidays.
Caroline's
going to
be so
napping
much fun.
Over the holidays. If you want to think of that, I encourage you.
Live audience, make some noise. Thanks for being part of it. Thank you.
Since I was a young boy.